Hello and welcome to Easy English. We've got a special thing on today. What I'm going to do is I'm going to read some nursery rhymes, and the nursery rhymes I'm going to read are... my dog just woke up. The nursery rhymes I'm going to read are from the Better Beginnings alphabet chart, and also from a flyer. A Better Beginnings flyer called Thanks Dad, Reading Nursery Rhymes with Your Children. So if you've got either of these resources from the Better Beginnings people, then it might be useful to also have this audio and video to remind you of the things you can do with the verses, and of course in some cases the tune, or one of the tunes, because some of them have more than one tune, so don't get into an argument about which is the right tune with somebody. So I'm going from the alphabet chart first. Useful thing to have around if you're reading to your children. There's an alphabet chart. I'm going to start with Humpty Dumpty.
Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again.
When you get to the word fall, if you like, you can be holding your child and you can pretend that they're falling, but of course don't drop them and look after them. Otherwise they won't want you to read it again. The next one is Hickory Dickory Dock.
Hickory Dickory Dock, the mouse ran up the clock. The clock struck one, the mouse ran down, Hickory Dickory Dock.
The next one is Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, one of the most well-known nursery rhymes.
Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are.
The next one in the little booklet is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once I caught a fish alive. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then I let it go again. Why did you let it go? Because it bit my finger so. Which finger did it bite? The little finger on the right.
Next one, Incy Wincy Spider, which here is written Incy Wincy Spider. So you'll see both.
Incy Wincy Spider climbed up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed poor Incy out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. So, Incy Wincy Spider climbed up the spout again.
And the last one in the chart is Hey Diddle Diddle, which you'll hear read or sung, so I'll do both. Hey diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle, the cow jumped over the moon. The little dog laughed to see such sport, and the dish ran away with the spoon.
Hey diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle, the cow jumped over the moon. The little dog laughed to see such sport, and the dish ran away with the spoon.
Okay. So you might also have the Better Beginnings flyer called Thanks Dad, Reading Nursery Rhymes with Children. And it's got a few extra ones on it, so I'm just going to go through those. I don't have a copy of it with me, but maybe you've got a copy. Either way, it has This Little Piggy. So this is a game played usually on the toes. I'm not going to stick my foot in the video, but I'm going to use my hand instead of my foot. So you might take the child's foot gently and gently squeeze the toes with the verse. This little piggy went to market. This little piggy stayed home. This little piggy had roast beef. This little piggy had none. And this little piggy was a wee little piggy. And he went wee, 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 all the way home. And you can tickle the child, but just gently. Don't hurt them or they won't want you to do it again. All right, next one is, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then you really ought to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Hello to any of my students who are doing this course. I'm a little teapot. This one's fun. I've actually done this in class. I'm a little teapot short. I haven't quite got the tune there. What's the tune for I'm a little teapot, Andrea? I'm a little teapot short and stout. Here is my handle, here is my spout. When I get all steamed up, hear me shout. Tip me over, pour me out. It's more or less the tune. Okay, the next one, ring-a-ring-a rosies. You can do this standing and dancing around in a circle with your child or as many people as you have in the room. Ring-a-ring-a-rosy, pocket full of posies. Tissue, tissue, we all fall down. And on down, you can fall down on the ground. Okay. Round and round the garden, usually played on the hand. So I'll demonstrate. Take the child's hand gently, and with your finger in the middle of the child's hand, go very gently. Round and round the garden, like a teddy bear. One step, two step, tickle them under there. So, again, everything gently because you don't want to scare them. The next one, very well known. Ba ba black sheep, have you any wool? Yes sir, three bags full. One for the master and one for the dame. And one for the little boy who lives down the lane. And don't let me catch any of you saying free. It's three. Three bags full. Get that tongue out of your mouth. Don't be lazy. Okay. And the last one in that flyer from Better Beginnings called Thanks Dad, Reading Nursery Rhymes with Children, is The Grand Old Duke of York, which I haven't heard for years. Going out of fashion, that one. Oh, the grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them up to the top of the hill and he marched them down again. And when they were up, they were up. And when they were down, they were down. And when they were only halfway up, they were neither up nor down. So, those were the nursery rhymes from two of the Better Beginnings publications. The alphabet chart here. Yellow one, and the flyer, which is called Thanks Dad, Reading Nursery Rhymes with Children. And if you don't have them, if you'd like to get them, you can probably contact the Better Beginnings people at the State Library and they'll help you out with that. And they'll probably give them to you for free, so it's pretty good. Now, we should say I'm not employed by Better Beginnings and I'm not authorised by Better Beginnings, but I'm sure they wouldn't mind me using their materials as a springboard and creating this audio and video so that you've got that maybe on your smartphone or on your computer to assist you. And if they do mind, I'll just take the video down. All right, good luck with that. And don't forget, the best way to do this sort of stuff is to have a time of day. Yeah, maybe before bed, before bedtime, as long as they've washed their teeth. A time of day when you can sit down, tell them a story, maybe sing a nursery rhyme or two. And if it's regular, if you're doing it at the same time every day, then it becomes much easier to do and to remember and it becomes part of your rhythm. Okay. Thanks.